In this lesson, we will be discussing the distributive property of multiplication, often referred to as multiplication over addition or subtraction. We will also mainly be focusing on distributing negative integers. But for review, for multiplication over addition, the distributive property is defined as a times the quantity b plus c equals a times b plus a times c. We say we distribute the a, meaning a is multiplied by both b and c, inside the parentheses, and the operation of addition remains the same. As an example, if we have the expression 5 times the quantity x plus 6, if we distribute the 5, we have 5 times x plus 5 times 6, which simplifies to 5x plus 30. For multiplication over subtraction, the distributive property is defined as a times the quantity b minus c equals a times b minus a times c. We say we distribute the a, meaning a is multiplied by both b and c inside the parentheses, and the operation of subtraction remains the same. As an example, if we have 2 times the quantity 3x minus 7, and we distribute the 2, we have 2 times 3x minus 2 times 7, which simplifies to 6x minus 14. So performing distribution with a positive integer is fairly straightforward. However, distributing a negative integer can get more involved. Let's take a look at distributing a negative integer over addition. Let's begin with the expression negative 6 times the quantity x plus 3. To clear the parentheses, we distribute negative 6, which gives us negative 6 times x plus negative 6 times 3. Simplifying, negative 6 times x is negative 6x, and negative 6 times 3 is negative 18, giving us the expression negative 6x plus negative 18, but we normally don't leave it in this form because adding a negative is equivalent to subtracting a positive. We would normally give the final expression as negative 6x minus 18. Notice how there's quite a few steps here, so we can think of this in a slightly different way. If we go back to the original expression, we know we distribute negative 6. Negative 6 times x is negative 6x. And then for the next product, because we have a negative 6 here and a plus 3 here, we can think of this as negative 6 times positive 3, which is negative 18. Because the product is negative, we will have minus 18. If the product is negative, we would have subtraction. If the product is positive, we would have addition. And now let's take a look at distributing a negative across subtraction. Let's begin with the expression negative 4 times the quantity 2x minus 9. To clear the parentheses, we distribute negative 4, which gives us negative 4 times 2x minus negative 4 times 9. Simplifying, negative 4 times 2x is negative 8x, and negative 4 times 9 is negative 36. Notice here we have minus negative 36, which is equivalent to plus 36. And therefore the final expression is negative 8x plus 36. Again, notice how we have several steps here, so we can think of this in a slightly different way to save time and keep track of the signs. Going back to the original expression, we know we distribute negative 4. The first product is negative 4 times 2x, which is negative 8x. And then for the next product, because we have negative 4 here and minus 9 here, we will think of the minus 9 as negative 9, or for 1 or 2, plus negative 9. And because negative 4 times negative 9 is positive 36, we just have plus 36. Again, if the product is positive, we have addition. If the product is negative, we have subtraction. And notice how we get to the final expression much faster and easier to keep track of the signs using this approach. Let's take a look at two more examples. Here we're asked to simplify the given expression, which means we need to clear the parentheses and combine like terms. And because we have subtraction here, we actually distribute negative 3 to clear the parentheses. And because we have minus 5 here, we think of this as a negative 5. And again, we can do this because the given expression is equivalent to 8 plus negative 3 times the quantity 4x plus negative 5. Let's go ahead and leave it in this form and distribute negative 3. We have 8, and then negative 3 times 4x is negative 12x, giving us minus 12x. And then negative 3 times negative 5 is positive 15, which gives us plus 15. Again, if that's confusing, we can take a look at the extra work below. If we distribute negative 3, negative 3 times 4x is negative 12x, but plus negative 12x is equivalent to minus 12x, which is what we have here. And then negative 3 times negative 5 is positive 15, which does give us plus 15. The last step is to combine like terms. 8 plus 15 is 23. The simplified expression is 23 minus 12x, or negative 12x plus 23. Let's take a look at one more example. Again, we want to simplify the given expression. We have 12 minus the quantity 2x plus 5. Because the 2x plus 5 is in parentheses, we are subtracting both terms inside the parentheses. One way to handle this, though, is to place a 1 in front of the parentheses and distribute negative 1 to clear the parentheses. Let's take this approach. So we have 12, and then if we distribute negative 1, we have negative 1 times 2x, which is negative 2x, giving us minus 2x. And then we have negative 1 times positive 5, which is negative 5, which gives us minus 5. Again, if we need to see the extra work, once we place the 1 in front of the parentheses, we could rewrite this as 12 plus negative 1 times the quantity 2x plus 5. And then if we distribute the negative 1, we can see we would get 12 plus negative 2x, plus negative 2x is equivalent to minus 2x, and plus negative 5 is equivalent to minus 5. And now we combine like terms. 12 minus 5 is 7. The expression simplifies to 7 minus 2x, or negative 2x plus 7. I hope you found this helpful.